Talk Shoe. Recorded live.
Oh, Wake up all the teachers, come to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, you jump the very best you can. Let it be.
Long here. Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
Did you hear that thing talking about our recording has been completed? Hold up, let me do this. Whoa, wait a minute. That's not planned.
It should be true. The devil is lying. We have a story here.
I just have to laugh because I'm not playing with this demon. Now let's do this again. One thing I know, we must be doing what is right, because anytime you have situations in the atmosphere that try and deal with your communication, to try and hinder, block, stop, or try and turn you away from that what the Lord has given you to do, what you do is you just keep on going as if nothing ever, ever got in your way. It's time for us to stop, block, and let the Lord lead us around these different little things that get in our way. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you this morning that we are aware of the forces of evil. I know that, Father, whatever you said in your word, that that you will do. Look upon your children today, Father. Lord, take falsehood and things away from us that you have not given us, and things, Lord, that we represent. Give us the vision to represent that which is just and right. Outside of all the things that the enemy try and bring in our life and try and dam up the flow, we speak breakthrough this morning over the lives of your people. We speak healing and deliverance over the lives of your people. Father, we command the forces of evil to be uprooted, broken, and destroyed this morning. We destroy every root of the enemy, Satan. We acknowledge, Father, Lord, that you have given us life, and that the life you've given us, Father, Lord, you've given us a Zoe life, an abundant life. We thank you this morning, God, that we're able to speak to sickness, and it too have to leave. We're able to speak to curses and evil things, and these things are uprooted and destroyed. Father, we ask you look upon your ministers today, Father, Lord, they have not told the whole truth, Father. Father, they preach not the word that we're living, the last, this end time message, knowing, Lord, that it'll be 400 years come 2019 that a nation been stuck in a land that is not theirs. Help us, Father, to remember that you've given us power over every unclean thing. We denounce the works of darkness, and we thank you for the light that has shined upon us. Help us to come out today, Father Lord. Every generational curse, God, we command it to go from the lives of our children, our siblings. We ask you, Father, now that you move by your spirit, Father Lord. Bring healing and deliverance to the minds, Lord. Then let us, Father Lord, confess our sins one between the other. Let us go and ask for forgiveness for the things that we've done, Father Lord. Oh, God, open our eyes that we may see. Open our ears that we may hear. Open our understanding that we may understand the truth today. Oh, Father, we ask that you bless the message today. Touch the messenger and every ear that hear. Touch the prophetess today, God. And Lord, you begin to unwind things, Lord, that she may show people and show a loved one the error that's in their life today, Father. Lord, take the burden off of her heart today, Father, Lord, and we return the burden, Lord, to those that have caused these burdens to be in the land today, Father, Lord. Help us as the older to speak to the younger, Lord, about these generational curses, Father, Lord, that is upon the children today, Father. Things that our forefathers, our daddies, our grandpa have done, Father Lord, and we ourselves have allowed these things to live, amen, through us, Lord, and now it's affecting our children, Lord. And the kids don't have any respect today, Father. Lord, return the children back to the father, and the fathers and mothers back to the children today, God. As we break every generational curse today, and Lord, we loose your anointing over their life today, that they would be healed, restored, Lord, and made free from all the evil, Father, Lord, that the enemy has been trying to speak over into their lives today. Father, we thank you, and we just give you the glory and the honor this morning, Father, for you are worthy of all these praises and glory, and we give you the glory now in the Most High, Yah Selah, and we thank God for Yahshua,
whom we know as Jesus the Christ. Amen and amen, 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 amen. Well, I praise him this morning. Hallelujah. We're getting ready to go over into a new episode. Amen. But I don't want you to forget the last episode, tripped by your lip and hung by your tongue. Amen. And we explained that the reason for that was because the Bible talks about in the book of James how that this tongue is unruly evil. It's always starting up some mess. It's like Michael Jackson. All we got to be starting something. Amen. We want to put an end to all this vain talking. We want to put an end to all this laziness, all this anybody, anything stuff. Let's be real in the sight of the Father today, and let's get healed, set free, and delivered. Hallelujah. Maybe you need to fall on your head like I did. Hallelujah. Amen. Since that fall on the top of my head, and he saved me, and I didn't have to go to the doctor. I didn't have nothing wrong with my brains. Amen. If anything, that drop on my head made me come clean with the Father. Amen. I'm sitting here today. I'm not telling you that I'm perfect. Hallelujah. But I'm sure trying to give him a perfect praise today. Hallelujah. So I want you all to pay attention to the word of God. Amen. You can call in to 724-444-7444. Access code 111-253. Amen. Or you can drop me a line at Kingdom Work. Kingdom Work, one word, 007 at gmail.com. We'll be glad to hear from you. Amen. Let us know the impact that this word has had on your life. Amen. The word of God comes to turn things around. Hallelujah. We need to be turned around today. Amen. We want to talk from the book of Colossians, the first chapter, the 13th verse. Amen. And I want to give it a topic: danger, uncertain times ahead. We're so caught up looking at what the president is doing and saying, amen, till we can't even hear what the Lord has said. Hallelujah. But he has given us victory in the midst of all of these crises and all these things that are going on today. Amen. He's already given us victory. So I don't want you to be alarmed. Amen. Someone was telling me yesterday about Donald Trump and how he said 12 hours of killing. Amen. And nobody's going to police. Excuse me, please. I don't want to hear about no mess like that. I'm here, amen, preaching love. I'm here preaching, amen, forgiveness. I don't want to hear about nobody getting murdered because the president stood up and said, go and murder people freely. And he's been murdering people. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to hear about the goodness, excuse me, of God. Hallelujah. So we're going to talk about danger. Hallelujah. Uncertain times ahead. Hallelujah. There are some people that is caught up in this third millennium. And these preachers are always preaching about, amen, a new era and a peace and prosperity, amen, and all of this stuff, amen, a time of rebirth, amen, when mankind, amen, is supposed to experience all of this, amen, a leap in knowledge and unlimited ability to bring about a vital utopia on earth. You ain't gonna be none of that. That's a lie. Hallelujah. You see, because with the word of God, amen, with the Bible, hallelujah, which has never once failed to foretell the future accurately, amen, as your trusted instruction manual. Hallelujah. See, you get a quite different picture, amen, one of uncertainty and trouble, where there will be distress of nation with perplexity. See, the Bible is telling us, amen, that, you know, that it's going to become a stress. Hallelujah. And let's just look at Luke 21 and 25 right quick to validate that. Amen. We'll come back to Colossians. Amen. I want to show you that these preachers are lying to you, talking about a new era, talking about how that this is going to happen. They're lying. It's not with, well, see, they're preaching some old time gospel. I want you to get into the new gospel, which is not new, which is happening right now. They way back there, amen, in a whole nother universe. And we're today, we're around about Luke 21. Amen. Luke 21, amen. And I once before I told you, amen, what happened when Harvey came. Amen. Now look, Luke 21. Take heed, Luke 21 and 8. And he said, take heed that you not be deceived. For many will come in my name, saying, I am he, and the time has drawn near. Therefore, do not go after them. When 2000 came, they talking about the world going to come to the end. Everybody went and parked up in Jerusalem. And he didn't come there. For he has already came. And he's in the earth today, this morning. Hallelujah. And he has angels on assignment on the behalf of your life. If you're going through a crisis, amen, you may have to go through. But I tell you one thing, if you mark time, you keep on crying out to him and telling him, Lord, I love you, I bless you, I thank you, hallelujah, he will bring you out. Yes, he will bring you through your situation today. Excuse me. Hallelujah. The time has drawn near. Therefore, do not go after them. But when you hear of wars and commotion, do not be troubled. Don't be troubled about what Donald Trump is saying. If Kim Jong-un or whatever they call him and Putin and Donald Trump, if they decide to have war, amen, that's what men do. Men have war. America has fought many wars. Hallelujah. And the reason for the war is because they want to turn in a new era. Men has always fought wars because they're tired of that person's rulership. And they want to get him out, get that nation out, and lord over that nation and strong them. But this land belongs to him, the Almighty God. Hallelujah. The all-seeing, he created this world. He created this vast, amen, utopia for the experience and for the gardening of the gardeners, whom are you and I. Hallelujah. So why would he destroy his creation? Excuse me, please. He don't want to destroy the creation. But since man has took it upon himself to try and spy out God, amen, he can let them destroy themselves. So it says here, you will hear of wars and commotion. Do not be terrified, for these things must come to pass first. But the end will not come immediately. See, every time I start talking about wars, we're going to have, oh, don't talk like that. See, people don't want to face the reality. They don't want to face up, amen, that God, amen, he did not put you on earth to live here the rest of your life, amen. But he put you on earth to be a demonstration of him, hallelujah, so that he can win these people back to him. Our Heavenly Father, amen, Yahuwah, he do not want to destroy you. Hallelujah. Why would he create you and love you and then turn right back around and kill you? Amen. I just don't find that to be true this morning. I don't find God to be, amen, a murdering God that wants to kill you. Hallelujah. It's what you put yourself into that gets you killed. Amen. Hallelujah. If you live godly and live for him, so what? Bring it on. If I die, let me die. Hallelujah. He said, if you love this world, you love your life, amen, like that, you're going to lose it. But if you don't love this old flesh, hallelujah, if you don't love it, amen, fall out of love with your flesh so you don't have to spend all that money trying to decorate that corpse. That thing is dying anyhow. Hallelujah. The Bible said, man, bone of a woman don't have but a few days, and them days are full of trouble. Our relatives and friends is acting a fool and mad at us, amen, because we don't do what they do. Hallelujah. We come around, they tiptoe all around us, amen, as if we were something, amen, spooky. Yeah, we're spooky, all right. Hallelujah. Because you got that sin underneath the rug. You need to pull that. I'm going to come snatch the rug off the floor, and all your sins going to jump up. Now, let's get this thing right. Prophets this morning talk about sin in the family, how that families are so divided, amen, to two first cousins getting married. Because they don't know one another. Two second cousins, first and second and third cousins get married, hallelujah, because we don't introduce our loved ones and siblings, amen, to our children. Child, I don't want them going around there. Them people's barbaric. That's your sister. That's your auntie. That's your uncle. That's your cousin. That's your nephew. So if they're barbaric, you is too. It's your job, amen, as the prophet is saying, I'm going to tell them. You tell them, hallelujah, and I'm going to help you tell them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then he said in the 10th verse, you all excuse me with these allergies. Then he said to them, nations will rise against nations and kingdom against kingdom. And there will be great earthquake in various places and famine and pestilence. And there will be fearful sights and great signs from heaven. They don't equate this with great signs from heaven. Lava running down the street as if it was water somebody spewed out. That stuff was real. That stuff was so hot until it run over the top of a car and cremate the whole car to ashes. Now, that's got to be mighty hot to just melt down the iron, the seats, and all the electrical components. All that stuff look all the same. It's a big heap of ash. I'm telling you now. It's time to preach the gospel the way it is. And this is what he said is going to happen. And it's happening. Hallelujah. And there will be fearful sights, great signs from heaven. But before all these things, they will lay their hand on you and persecute you, deliver you up to the synagogues and the priests. They don't want you in the church. You will be brought before kings and rulers for my name's sake. But it will turn out for you as an occasion for testimony. So when you have to go before all this craziness, the Father will, amen, allow you to be like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Amen. King Nebuchadnezzar, he said, y'all come out. And when they came out, their lifestyle was a testimony to King Nebuchadnezzar. He told everybody in the kingdom, worship Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Worship their gods. Forget about all these gods I put up. Tear them down and worship the true and living, hallelujah, God, amen, Yah. Worship him and he only shall we worship. Hallelujah. So many thoughts going in my mind right now. Amen. Revelation 18, come out of her. Amen. Stop spending your money on the rockets. Amen. Who you supporting? Who you with? Look like you with the Astros. Everything on you. Socks say Astros. Your shirt say Astros. Your pants say Astros. Your hat say Astros. One of your eyeballs don't say Astros. Now, that's nothing wrong with, amen, going out and buying these things for an occasion. But if that's all you're going to do is be a Rocket fan, be a Dallas, I'm a Dallas Cowboy fan, but I guarantee Montoya, I have one Dallas Cowboy hat, and besides my cowboy hats, because that I am is a cowboy, amen, born a cowboy, rode horses, ride horses, broke horses, sold horses, bought horses, hallelujah, glory to God. But this word is true this morning, hallelujah. And then we talking about, amen, a millennium, amen, how this millennium is going to usher in a new era of peace and prosperity, amen. There ain't going to be any peace. Jesus said, amen, that a man is going to be against his son against him, the mother against the daughter-in-law against the mother-in-law, father-in-law against the son-in-law, vice versa. And then all these things going to happen. And then you turn around and you're looking for someone to tell you about some peace. You're not going to have no peace. The only peace you're going to have is to get with your family and tell your children, amen, hallelujah, the things not to do, the things that you've been through, the things that you suffer from, the things that, amen, you allowed the enemy to bring you to. This time for us to stand up and to declare the truth, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're running out of time. We're running out of time. Got to get it told. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he says that that we need to sell it, but it will turn out for your occasion. Excuse me. I have to start getting up a little early so I can get all this out of my system so it don't be trying to block me or stop me. Hallelujah. Amen. I wish he would try to cut my voice off. I just go make me a bunch of signs, and I have signs hanging all off my ankles. I have, matter of fact, I'm gonna stick my sign on my truck. I got some signs that say one way to heaven, and that one way to heaven is according to, amen, 1 Corinthians 13 chapter, love. If you ain't got no love, amen, ain't nothing else gonna get you in but love. All that other stuff you think that God is liking, he don't like it. Hallelujah. He didn't let you do it. My God, from glory. Amen. Therefore, sell it in your hearts, not to meditate beforehand on what you're going to say when you go and stand before these foolish people. I'll give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversary will not be able to, amen, contradict or resist. You will be betrayed even by parents and brothers. You see that, woman of God? You're going to be betrayed by your parents, your brothers, your relatives, and friends. And they will put some of you to death, and you will be hated by all for my name's sake. But not a hair of your head shall be long. By your patience possess ye your soul. So you got to be patient this morning. Hallelujah. You got to be patient so that your soul, man, hallelujah, can be possessed. We need to be possessed not by the things of this world. We don't need to be possessed by some demon. We need to be possessed by the word of God. Hallelujah. I didn't come here, amen, looking for no crowd, looking for no one to pat me on the back. I've come here to tell it to you the way it's written in the book. I haven't changed not one word. Hallelujah. 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 Verse 20 of Luke 21, but when you see Jerusalem surrounded by armies, right now they're surrounded by armies right now. So why I don't hear these preachers talking about this? It's not that they don't know. It's just that they don't want to, amen, to disrupt, erupt, amen. They don't want their message where they get their money from. It's time to quit it. It's just time to just stop all this foolishness and to tell the truth according to this Bible. Here it is. We got a road map. Here it is. We have an instruction manual. Amen. Amen. This instruction manual, it gives a different picture, amen, of the uncertain times and troubles, amen, that's going to come upon this earth. Amen. It said, distress of nations and perplexity. Hallelujah. We're living in that. People are running because fires are coming, burning up their horses, their homes, their cars. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. Fannie Mae and these other people, they call on FEMA. Amen. FEMA to run out of. Oh, my God. Come on, people. Stop looking at, amen, your Savior, Hartford Insurance Company. They can't save you from a fire. They might can try to help you replace what you lost. Amen. But they can't replace no life. They can't bring your horse back. You may buy another dog, but they certainly can't bring your dog back. Amen. You need to be hooked up, amen, on this word this morning so that you can be wise and know, hallelujah, that these things must come to pass. But the Bible says, but the end is not in sight. Hallelujah. Nations rising against nations. Hallelujah. Kingdoms against kingdoms. Putin want to, amen, fight, amen, Canada and Mexico, amen, and all these different places. We act like these people here are foreigners, are strays. We all came out of one God, hallelujah. We all come out of Eden. Eden is in Africa. All of us, amen, had dealings in Africa, hallelujah. Your ancestors, amen, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Bible talks about a nation, amen. Donald Trump, amen, he stood up and he penned H.R. 1242. In commemoration of the Negroes being in America for 400 years come 2019. 1619, amen, we come into this land, land of the free, home of the brave, and we put a tireless effort. We have worked in here. We've loved Martin Luther King, lost his life. Amen. Many, many, many good, great men, amen, lost their life. President Kennedy lost his life. Amen. Many others lost their life over trying to bring about peace and righteousness. Hallelujah. The only thing you can do, amen, you don't need to preach no peace. You need to preach, amen, acceptance and coming together. Preach love. Hallelujah. Teach people how to judge their understanding. Amen. 2 Corinthians 13:5, examining themselves. Amen. Hallelujah. And we're coming to a close. We got to pick this thing up tomorrow. Amen. This is a good word today. Hallelujah. We need to know, amen, hallelujah. He says Jerusalem is going to be surrounded by armies. They know its desolation is near. Then let those who are in Judea flee to the mountain. Let those who are in the midst of her depart. And let not those who are in the country enter her. For these are the days of vengeance. God is going to turn things around. That all things which were written may be fulfilled. God didn't jot this in his book, and it's just going to pass away, and it'll be like, oh, but he didn't do this. Oh, he's going to do everything that's written in the book. That's why you all don't want to look over here in his book and get an understanding. This is New Testament doctrine. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the days of vengeance and all things which are written may be fulfilled. But woe to those who are pregnant and for those who are nursing babes in those days, for there will be great distress in the land and wrath upon this people. And they will fall by the edge of the sword and be led away captive into all nations, and Jerusalem will be trampled by Gentiles until the time of the Gentiles are fulfilled. Jerusalem today are trampled by the Gentiles, the Edomites. The Gentiles are those, amen, that God allowed to be partaker, excuse me, of his divine nature. Remember, the Gentiles were estranged from God. They were foreigners, amen. But he allowed them through Yahshua, amen, to become a part. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 25th verse said, and there will be signs in the sun and in the moon. August the 25th, we were looking at the solar eclipse. We were looking at the solar eclipse right here, August the 25th, when Harvey came. Amen. So this is a prophecy that's fulfilling right there. That one right there is fulfilled already. It already came to pass. And in the earth, and distress of nations with perplexity, and the seas and the wave will be roaring. On the 25th or the 26th of August, the water came up out of the earth. On the 26th, in Luke 21:26, it says, men's hearts failing them for fear and expectancy of those things which are coming on the earth. For the power of heaven will be shaken. Hallelujah. So Luke 21:26, the water, men's hearts were, they were looking for boats. I was right here looking at them. I was looking at it. I drove around the corner. The water kept rising. The water came out of the levee. Amen. And the people had to have boats on the other side, amen, of 1462. That neighborhood was flooded with water. Amen. I know I stood over and watched water 4 foot deep, and it got even deeper than that. And they had boats. They had their bags on their back. And they were coming out. They should have been coming out, crying out to the Lord. And said, Lord, we repent. Because it's some more water on the way. So the Holy Spirit told me, said, go and get your life preservers. So you come in my garage right now. And there are 4, 5, 6 life jackets that are laying there in that garage. They're not laying there all for me. They for some of my neighbors. Hallelujah. And I've warned everybody, go and buy you a life jacket. Because you can't jump on my back. You cannot be trying to jump on your wife's back. You mothers, y'all can't pack your children out that water. You got too many kids. They're going to drown you. Go and get them a life jacket. Even though the Bible said that the world would not be destroyed by water, it's not going to be destroyed by water. But we got some water going to come. We got water coming now, today. Hallelujah. Down in College Station, hallelujah. It's supposed to have flooded. I don't know if it didn't or it did, but I sure was praying and said, Lord, please take care of your people, Lord. Don't do like you did for me. He didn't let that water, but the water came up on my street about 2.5 feet. But I went out there and I started blowing that shofar. I got God's attention, got the neighbor's attention too. They were looking like, one of was wrong with that crazy man. But I tell you what, I told them, hey, look out, the water going down. I got their attention and told them, look at it, let them know what I was doing was not foolish. And I got to get back to blowing my shofar, getting back out on these corners. Hallelujah. God is working in my life. Amen. He's telling me what direction to go in. People's called, repenting of their sin, things they've said about me and things that they did to me. Amen. To go was ungodly and was wrong when all I did was come to that city to bring a breakthrough. Hallelujah. And they miscarried. Amen. They were mad because when I came up in the churches, amen, demons began to scream out and run and began to act up. And people, you know, they don't want the leaders do not want to be exposed. All the leaders that I've ever ran into that God began to expose and cleanse their life in front of the congregation, they were mad at me, and they do not touch me. They don't want me around them till to this day. You see, but with their mouth, they say they love me, but their actions say we don't want you. And this is the way that they're doing, amen, the women and men of God that God has chosen in this hour. So I want you to be blessed. I want you to go back over Luke. I have got to get this allergy out of me this morning. And the only way for me to do this is to get up and get out. Go out in the sun. I need to go to the S-U-N this morning. I already got the S-O-N working in me, but I need some S-U-N. But I praise and I thank him this morning that I was able. And we'll come back to Luke 21 and the 25th verse, and we'll come back if the Lord permits. To Colossians 1 and 13. And we'll just begin to just read, amen, what he said in this day and age, what's going to really happen, amen, in this land. So I want you all to be prayerful, amen, and to hold on to your confidence because he has a great reward, amen. Don't let the enemy steal your joy today, amen. Don't let him steal your joy. Don't let him rob you of your righteousness. Amen. Amen. Anyone have any words this morning they'd like to say before we close the segment out this morning? Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
And I came forward with the word.
Yes, Father.
Thank God for you. Thank God for waking you up. Thank God healing your body. In the name of Jesus, our family, in the name of Jesus, come together as God called us to do his will. And I want his will for the Lord. Amen.
Yes, hallelujah. Amen. That is the most important thing now, what you said, is that we need to be doing his will. You know, and when we do his will, certainly you're going to get hurt. Certainly you're going to see things that you don't like to see. But as we read his word, his word tells us that they're going to kill you. They're going to kill you with their mouth. They're going to hurt you so bad that you say, child, I ain't going there no more. But he said it's going to turn out for an occasion. Amen. When the truth of God is living and residing in us, it just told us in the scriptures that our loved ones, they're going to be the one that's going to persecute us. They're going to be the one. It's going to start with the family. And the family going to sit there, and they're going to act like you some stranger. You know, and then they're going to talk about you, and they're going to say, child, I don't pay no attention to him. I've heard that many times. I don't pay no attention to him. But it don't bother me. You don't need to pay no attention to me. Pay attention to the word. Pay attention to your life. Pay attention to what he said. If the Bible said it, then wonder why they don't believe it. They don't believe it because they don't care. They don't care about truth. Amen. Truth has left the earth. But I want to be like Michael Jackson. Amen. Michael Jackson, He said, amen. He was asking him to change his ways. Amen. You know, and that's what we need to do. Hallelujah. People look at Michael Jackson one way, but I look at Michael Jackson, you understand me, as he was a spiritual icon. As a little boy, he started singing, amen. And as he got older, before he passed away, amen, he wrote that song. Whoever wrote it, he sung it, amen. And I love this song, and I want you to listen to it in closing. And close it out. I want you to hear what he said.
Lord, make a change.
See, he gonna make a change.
Gonna make me right. And I turned up the clock. My favorite one to quote. The way that it blew in my mind. Here in the street, but not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them? I saw a street guy from broken bottle town, and one of them spoke. They followed each other on the window. They got nowhere to go. Thank you.
Jesus.